Chapter 2.
Hunting in the Kelp Forest.
Sandy's mother whistles. Whistling is how she calls Sandy.
Come and get lunch!
The other otter mothers whistle to their otter pups. It is lunchtime for all of them. All of the swimming and diving has made Sandy hungry.
Will we have kelp crabs for lunch, Mom?
Sandy asks.
Perhaps,
her mother says.
May we have sea urchins for lunch? They taste so good!
Sandy says.
We may,
her mother says.
How about some nice juicy sea snails?
All of those can be our lunch,
her mother says.
Get ready to dive down deep, my little pup.
Sandy takes a big breath of air. She fills her big lungs. She follows her mother underwater. They see a jewel-top snail. It is eating a kelp frond in the mid-kelp level.
Hi, Jewel!
Sandy says as she swims past. Sandy and her mother swim all the way to the ocean floor. Sandy's mother grabs a spiny sea urchin with her claw and a rock with her other claw. She puts the sea urchin under her arm. She uses the sharp rock to knock a mussel off the sea floor. She puts the mussel under her arm with the sea urchin. Sandy does the same thing. They swim up to the surface of the water. Sandy's mother rolls onto her back. Sandy does the same thing. Sandy and her mother bite open the sea urchins with their sharp front teeth. They lick the tasty sea urchin meat.
Yum, yum!
Sandy says.
Sea urchins are my favorite meal.
That is good to hear,
Sandy's mother says.
Sea urchins eat the kelp in the ocean. We need to eat sea urchins so that they do not destroy our home.
I want to eat more sea urchins,
Sandy says. She licks her lips. She licks her paws.
I can eat sea urchins all day.
First, we must eat our mussels,
her mother says. Sandy takes the mussel out from under her arm. She floats on her back and uses her claws to try to open the shell. But the shell does not open. She pulls harder and twists it. The shell still does not open.
Watch me,
Sandy's mother says. She puts the rock on her stomach. She hits the mussel on the rock. The shell breaks open. Sandy's mother eats the juicy mussel. Sandy thinks that is a good idea. She takes out her rock and hits her mussel on it. It does not open. Sandy hits it again. It still does not open. She hits it one more time. And this time, the shell opens. She uses her claw to pull out the mussel and eats the tasty meat. Sandy and her mother dive for food many more times. Sandy's mother catches a rockfish with her claws. Sandy's mother digs in the ocean bottom. She gets a clam. She opens the clam by hitting it on a rock. They eat snails, kelp crabs, sea urchins, and rockfish. When they finish eating, Sandy is full and sleepy.
You must clean yourself before you take a nap,
Sandy's mother tells her. Sandy spins around and around in the water. Spinning in the water is fun, and it cleans the food off her thick fur. She licks all the food off her paws and claws. She rubs her face to clean her long brown whiskers. When she is old, her face and whiskers will turn white like her mother's. Sandy's mother says,
"Come and lie on my stomach, little pup."
Sandy's mother floats on her back in the water. Sandy climbs on her mother's stomach. Sandy's mother picks up the fur on her pup and blows on it. She brushes Sandy's fur. She blows on Sandy's fur. This fluffs Sandy's fur and fills it with warm, dry air. When Sandy's mother finishes fluffing Sandy's fur, it is so full of warm air that she floats. She cannot dive now. Her fur is too fluffy. She rolls in the kelp fronds. The kelp fronds will be her bed. Then she holds paws with her mother and yawns. All the other otters lie in the kelp fronds and hold paws. This keeps them together in a raft while they sleep.
Sweet dreams, little pup,
Sandy's mother tells her. She coos to her. The water is cold. The sun is warm. The waves are soft. The soft ocean waves rock the raft of otters to sleep.